This week, Captain Richard and my buddy Alan come aboard to help move Symphony up the coast to Norfolk from West Palm Beach. Along the way, we talk, and we talk, and we go through a 40-knot storm, and then we talk, and talk, and then we see a bunch of dolphins, and then we talk, and then we talk some more. You've been warned, there's a lot of talking in this one. 'Cause even in the baddest, there's peace, drowning out the voices all around me through all of this chaos. You are writing a symphony, oh. We left off last week in Palm Beach, where we were dropping off Aaron, Ivan, and Oliver, and picking up crew for our journey north around Hatteras to Norfolk. Part of that crew consisted of Captain Richard. While we now have a lot of miles under our belt, I thought it would be a good idea to have him along to help navigate the longer passage with weather that is a lot different than island hopping in the Bahamas.
Oh yeah, of course. So now we need to see what the weather is like, but in order to do that, I will have to turn my inReach on. Since the button has died, the only way to do that is to put this thing in here. There we go.
It's like a charm.
My buddy Alan also came along. He's one of the more relaxed people I know, and he loves sailing.
All right, we're approaching our first evening on our passage, and it's dead calm out here. But the current is extremely fast. We've got one engine on, about 2,000 RPMs, and we're at 9 knots. Yeah, it's pretty wild.
You're not very fast.
8.645. That's insane, man.
Well, that's the Gulf Stream for you.
But it doesn't even look like there's a current. That's the craziest part.
Can't tell out here. You can see a little bit of a motion.
We're in the Gulf Stream and the current is fast. We have one engine on, 2,000 RPMs, and we're making 9 knots speed over ground. At this rate, in one day, we'll cover 200 miles. It won't be like that the whole way, but it's pretty fast. It's kind of neat.
Hello. This is the start, or the middle of my shift, day two. 6 to 8 shift, and right now we're going 7.5 knots with 3 knots of current behind us and 17 knots of wind. We have the main and the jib up, main with a reef in it, and jib all the way out, so not too bad, but
yeah, this is pretty nice.
Look at the sunset in the sky, it's like pink.
This is my night shift from 2 to 4. Right now we're going 7.5 knots. Need 2 knots of current now, which isn't ideal, but you know. Alright, I'll be back at the end of my shift. Alrighty, it's the end of my shift now. We're going 8 knots there for a bit. It's 3:57 in the morning. Got a couple boats around us. A little storm on the radar.
This was not a little storm, as it turned out.
And I mean, it's been a pretty uneventful shift.
It's 4:30 in the morning of the 13th. We left on the 11th at 2 in the afternoon. And we're getting closer to Hatteras. And everything's been really smooth so far. There's a line of thunderstorms to our port side about 3 miles off, and I think it's eventually gonna get here. But, you know, it's just rain. I can see a little bit of lightning, but not a ton. It's fairly boring, you know? We're just cruising along, watching a lot of shows and eating meals, and that's about it. Just playing with sails and trying trying to get the most speed out of the wind as we can. So it's so far pretty uneventful. The storms might make it interesting, but you know, this just happens. There's storms out here. There's storms all the time, and you just have to be comfortable with that. It looks like it's not a giant system, but it looks like it's moving in generally the same direction we are. So when we get into it, we'll be in it for a long time.
As it went, we hit the storm shortly after that, and Richard came up to go through what we needed to do. Unfortunately, I filmed none of it, but we saw 40 knots of wind while we were in the middle of it. We decided to head into the storm, kept our wind angle at 20 degrees, and with just the main out with one reef in, we were good. We ended up picking up a hitchhiker after the storm, and he looked pretty worn out.
83 miles.
83 miles. A pigeon really far away from land.
I've never seen a pigeon land on a boat. You know, they're usually not out there, but he might have got caught in that storm.
And just got blown over.
He just got blown out.
Yeah.
It's my 10 o'clock to noon shift right now. I woke up and the swells had increased because we had a pretty big storm last night, apparently, where it was gusting up to 40 knots. So it's now 6 to 8 foot swells sometimes. And like it's threes most times, but sometimes you just get a really big wave and it shifts the entire boat backwards and forwards, so.
It's sunset, night 3. We are 165 miles from Hatteras. Got like a day and a half to go to Norfolk. That's our best guess. Other than the storm we had this morning on my shift at 4 a.m., it's been really easy. Seas have been calm. Wind has been okay. We have good wind now. We have 16 to 18 behind us. We're wing on wing. And we've got a preventer on the main, and we're just pegged, making really good time. This has been a decent experience. The only other time I've ever done this was with Captain Richard on a delivery down to West Palm. And that was the same kind of experience. This is more fun because there are more people on the boat. It's great talking with Richard, and I'm still learning new things. I had a long list of questions for him, and I keep on throwing the questions out every once in a while. Should be done with the list by the time we get there. Bittersweet, because I know that we only have a day and a half till we get to Norfolk. Then we go through all the motions of putting the boat up, which will be fun in itself, but I'm ready to get that done. I'm ready to put the boat up and not worry about it for about 3 months while we go travel. So there's a little bit of that, just anticipating being done. So that's a weird feeling, but you know, day and a half to go, and I'm sure we'll have some more adventures and maybe a few more storms along the way, but smooth sailing so far.
It's my night shift right now. It's 3:35 in the morning.
Six knots, and our ETA
to Cape Hatteras is today in the late afternoon, early evening.
There's usually not a lot to do while you're on watch, so even seeing a container ship is interesting. You'll know everything about that ship, and you'll tell the next guy on shift all about it.
Yeah, he's going to be 1.62 nautical miles away from us.
All right, we're on day 4. According to our calculations, we've got less than 24 hours until we make it to Norfolk. We're 6 hours out from making the turnaround Hatteras. Weather looks decent, waves are decent, speed's good. It's been a pretty painless passage so far. it's interesting the different emotions you go through out here when you're, you know, pretty isolated for several days at a time. There are moments of happiness, like finding good wind or hitting up speed or getting a fish on the line. Then there are moments where it's just kind of sad or you're gloomy. The weather affects you a lot. You know, this morning it was gray and cloudy when I went down to take a nap. Got up and it's sunny and clear, and my mood couldn't be different between the two times. So it's just interesting how humans work when in a small group by themselves for a longer period of time. It'll be interesting to see what longer passages are like. I'm sure we're gonna do things longer than 4 or 5 days someday. And doing this is really helping me understand what it's going to be like. So when we do have to do an 8-day passage or a 10-day passage, I think William and I are gonna be really prepared for it, and we'll be able to prepare Aaron for it as well.
Talk about ups and downs. These dolphins showed up at just the right time. I'm gonna stop yapping so you can just watch and enjoy them. It was awesome.
There's one right there. Woohoo! Yeah, there's a bunch right here. Oh, look at them!
So fast.
Oh,
good job, buddy.
As we got closer to Hatteras, the waves got a lot bigger and the winds picked up a bit. Luckily, it was all at our back, so it was comfortable, but it sure was crazy looking.
17 out of it.
We're sailing?
Yeah, no, it's 6, 8 knots now. 6, 6, 6, 7, 6, 8.
Good enough to get there?
Yeah, we'll make it to Hatteras in an hour.
We finally got to turn the motors off and we're sailing and it's beautiful. Unfortunately, we have to turn the engines back on because we're about to get to the Hatteras waypoint, turn right up, and we'll have like 10 degrees of wind on our nose. So we got a little sailing in. It's been a great voyage so far. We've got another 125 miles to go, and then we'll be done. All right, we have made it around Hatteras, spent the night just beating into the waves. My shift last night was really low. I think I've been talking about highs and lows, and it was a low one. From 4 a.m. to 6 a.m., I think we covered about 5 miles. It was so slow. We're running what I think is fairly low on fuel. We still have enough to get there, but we needed to put more cans in the tanks just so we can have some breathing room. Now we're making progress. We still have an engine on just to try to get some speed, but we've got both sails up. We're sailing really tight to the wind. Hopefully it'll clock around. But yeah, it was miserable last night. I think everybody had a terrible time of it. Just getting beat. There was a wave that made it all the way up into the lounge next to the helm, which was surprising. These passages, you'll see a lot of everything. You'll have highs, like seeing the dolphins come visit you for 15 minutes, and then you'll have lows, like last night, where it seems like you're never gonna get there. And that's probably my big takeaway from this, is that you have to be even keeled about how you're thinking. You need to take the highs and take the lows and understand that that's all just part of it. You've just gotta be safe and straightforward with how you're thinking, how you're planning your journey, how you're dealing with challenges, and eventually you'll get there safe and sound. So, no joking around. Give me your serious thoughts. What do you think of this passage so far?
It's been fun.
Fun?
I've had a good time.
Even last night when we were getting beaten up.
Yes, because I slept.
Yeah, I slept, you were on watch.
Yeah, it was just the most boring time of my life because we were going 2 knots. So, what more could I do other than this?
What's been your high point of the journey?
Going 12 knots.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Duh.
What's been your...
And the dolphins.
Okay. I was thinking that.
Yeah, that was pretty dope.
What's been your lowest point?
Last night.
Last night, yeah.
I ate a little bit last... too much food.
Oh, yeah. William ate... How many pieces of pizza did you eat last night?
8 or 9.
You would think you would learn. Like our first voyage out, you ate like 80 things in your stomach.
Hey, but I did not throw up.
That's true. You didn't throw up this time.
I just sat on my
belly ached.
I whined, which I'm very good at. So I got to do something I was good at.
We almost caught a mahi-mahi.
Yeah, almost that caught was, two.
Yeah.
But they snapped the line.
Yeah, they took the first. We lost our first lure of the season. Kind of sucks.
But. And they ripped off the entire thingy, so we just did not feel like retying the leader.
What else? What else? What's your takeaway? Have you learned anything on this trip?
Nope, learned nothing.
Oh, come on. Richard has to have taught you something.
Oh, yeah, I've learned a lot. Yeah. How to bring in the trip by myself and take it out by myself.
Yeah.
So to... And
we learned a lot about
traveler and raising the main
and working with the preventer.
Yeah.
I learned that the way that Navionics works, you can spend $200 on all of the southern United States, Mexico, South America, all of the Caribbean. That's $200 for the map. You want this little area here, and it's another $150. And I didn't do it. So we're gonna have to travel into Norfolk using our iPad for the charts, because I didn't realize I needed to buy another thing. And you can't download it. You have to buy an SD card from the manufacturer.
So we had a lot of highs and lows along the way. But in the end, the seas got smooth and we had a glorious last run into the Chesapeake. We learned a lot on this trip, and I think we are better prepared for next season as we tackle longer distances. Stay tuned next week, we'll cover how we haul the boat out, then we go over our summer plans. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next week.